Hi, this is Phil Hinton and welcome to part two of our coverage from the Pioneer 2008 product launch. In this episode, we talk about the future of Curo Plasma technology, and I started by asking Jim about the deal with Panasonic to provide glass from the 10G sets onwards and how he's seen the future for Curo.
Well, obviously, I'm an enthusiast about this as well, and I've been at Pioneer a long time. I've been at Pioneer about 17 years. So I was not shocked because obviously at the end of the day, this is the real reason behind it. If I was to answer the question why, first of all, is that at the end of the day, I've always maintained we're a very small brand. We can make the best glass in the world. We can make a very good television, if not the best television in the world, but on a very small scale. And actually that scale is, you know, some manufacturers will make between 30 and 50 million panels a year, the largest. We'll make about a tenth of that, if I'm honest. And of course, you can't make it for the same price. It's as simple as that. Whilst you can maintain a premium against your competitors with a better product, there reaches a point where that premium can only go so far and people aren't willing to pay for that extra feature or extra, in this case, black level and colour performance. So we were conscious of that, and it became obvious to us that really the glass was the most expensive factor in this, and in order to be more competitive, like many other manufacturers, we'd need to work with somebody to procure or make glass for us. The deal basically that's been struck, as I understand it, is that Matsushita, we will retain all the patents on our glass. So things like crystal emissive layer, that was a Pioneer invention and unique to us, our direct colour filter, even our deep waffle rib construction. I'm not privy yet to what the glass may or may not incorporate, this glass that's being made by Matsushita using some of Pioneer's technology. It may use all of those features, for example. It may only use part of them. But the deal basically is that in doing that, and holding on to our patents, we'll then procure a quantity of glass from Matsushita. We'll both benefit as brands, obviously, from that glass and from the combined technology. And there is a commitment there to work for the future as well, to make better and better glass for the future, using the best of both of our technologies and the best of both of our engineering capacities as well. Some of our factories may well close. We may see some of our engineers move over to work with Panasonic. It's not unlikely. Other facilities that we've got will move over to assembly, because of course we'll now have to assemble a module that we buy in of glass. But the core thing and the key thing that we need to get across, and I think again CES, I used this in my demonstration today, is a good example of that. The super black dem that we saw out there, which was a bit like a magic show with circles spinning out of thin air and it hanging in space in a darkened room, which amazed a lot of people that saw it. It amazed me. It was probably the most amazing dem I've seen in my career. That's not just about the glass, that's about the engine behind it. That was about eliminating any luminance from the cells between going from black to white and back and forth. And the discharge of those cells and the accuracy in which you can do that, that's in part how the product this year has got blacker. We haven't made a lot of differences to the glass. It is a new filter on this year's model, but we haven't made a lot of differences to the glass. It's about the way we're processing the engine behind it. So that is where we'll continue to drive Curo forward. Although the glass may be sourcing separately, as do many other brands out there, to be fair. Sony are an example of that, with the Bravia engine then bolted on the back of it. It becomes their own. We will do the same with Curo and put our own identity on the product and, of course, design as well. So I'm sure there's a long future ahead for Curo product.
Well, that's one thing I wanted to pick up on from the press conference, and certainly from what we saw in Vegas with the contrast concept. There's an awful lot of assumption out there that 10G is going to offer that kind of performance. Are we even close to that, or is it more likely that we're still trying to get what must have been quite a bit of processing behind that screen down to an acceptable size?
Well, that's it at the end of the day, and I think that's the key thing. I mean, to be honest, I don't know the true answer to it. I imagine, obviously, that our challenge is to go further each year. And now, obviously, we're using the glass separately. And as I said, with Panasonic, there's probably great opportunities to get to push that to new boundaries. I'm sure they were equally impressed with the demonstration they saw at CES. Many other manufacturers commented on it. And indeed, the 9mm product we showed as well. But you're right. It's about how are we processing and driving that. I'm sure there was a lot of electronics hidden behind there somewhere to produce that. Because it's certainly not down to a piece of silicon yet, and that's what it's about. We're now reducing all of that engineering and technology that they develop behind that down to a piece of silicon or a chip that they can actually use within the circuit. That takes a lot of money and time to do that. So again, that's really the heart and the engine, if you like, behind Curo for the future. Let's see what 10G does bring. Maybe, who knows? I look forward to it. I bet it will be exciting anyway, one way or the other.
Well, I think we're getting ahead of ourselves talking about 10G anyway, because, I mean, we're talking about the end of next year. Yep. We're talking about this year and this year's launch, and obviously a screen that's going to be around for a good 12 months, if not longer.
Yep.
And on the performance that I've seen today, I think you're onto a winner. So, Jim, congratulations and well done.
Thank you very much indeed. Thanks, Phil.